All right, I had somebody email me the other week, and they asked, in Wing Chun, when you apply it, would you ever come in and tan and punch at the same time? Well, the way that we do our Wing Chun in here, the answer is no. We would never come in and try to apply one blocking technique and one striking technique at the same time. And the reason for that is actually lies within Silam Tao. If we look at Silam Tao teaches us many things, obviously from starting from our center to how to move our arms in many different directions and come back to cover the center. But it's also teaching us how to naturally move our arms to create some natural generated power. And the two places that we looked to do that is right at the very beginning of Silam Tao, the Chir Kung punch, push-pull punch. And then also, the other place when we do in the second section of the Silam Tao is the double punch, two hands coming forward, two hands coming backwards. That's the way that your arms can naturally apply power. Just think about, for example, if you do a bench press, right? Well, if I do a bench press, would you ever come in here and press like your right arm forward and your left arm out to the side? No, because you'd never be able to get your body behind that fully. The other punch, the centerline punch, is like a bicycle crank. One crank going down, one crank going up, just to create natural circular energy. So if you look at it from that point of view, that's why I would never come in here and tan one way, for example, and punch with my other hand towards the center, because I'm not going to allow my body to create the natural power from that. So also, if I come from here and try to punch this way and push out here, then again, which is my body going to be behind? Is my body going to be behind the strike, or am I going to put the body behind the blocking hand? Natural body movements don't occur in that fashion. That's why we don't do it that way. The way that we block here, I have to always exchange, hit, block and then hit, block and then hit. Now I can hit and control, that's different though. But if he came in and just did punch, I would never come in here, tan and punch at the same time. I come in, tan, and then strike off that. Now, here's my control hand, that's okay, because now I'm affecting and controlling his center. And then from here, when I do like lap chop, again, affecting and controlling his center with the control hand of the lap chop at that time. But I never want to come in here and split my power between going like whatever, one blocking hand and one striking hand. All right, hope that helps. Any questions, feel free to write us.